Hello dear students, today we will learn about constants and literals in PLSQL. So a constant holds a value that once declared does not change in the program. A constant declaration specifies its name, data type and the values and allocates storage for it. The declaration can impose not null constant or null constraints also. So how to declare a constant? A constant is declared using the keyword constant. As I told you before in my previous lecture, it requires an initial value and does not allow that value to be changed. So here is the example to show the use of constant. So pi is a constant. Constant keyword is used to make it constant. Number is the data type. Pi will contain the data, numeric data, and this is the value we want to use in place of pi. So this is an example which shows the declaration of a constant. Now here is the code which will show how to declare a constant in a PLSQL block. So we will go on live SQL prompt to run this code. So this is the live prompt. This is the code. So first we will declare a constant. We want to declare pi as a constant number. Then this is the value which is related to pi. So here is a block in which we have used radius, and then we have to calculate the diameter and the circumference and area of a circle. So basically we want to calculate circumference, area and diameter using the radius, and pi will be used in this, and we created pi as a constant, or we defined pi as a constant. So this is the declaration. First declaration constant. Then other declaration, what we have to use other than pi, we have to use radius, diameter, circumference and area. All that we defined data type, number to all of them, and then the precision is also given there. Then in the begin statement, processing will start. Firstly, we will assign a value to the radius 12.5, then diameter is calculated using the formula radius into 2, then circumference is calculated using 2 into pi into radius, then area pi into radius into radius. Then we have to calculate the after calculating the output, we have to print that output, or we have to show that output on the screen. So that's why we have used dbms underscore output dot put underscore line for every number numeric value or for every variable. So radius, diameter, circumference and area. Radius we have given, and diameter will be calculated by die, and circumference is calculated by circumference obviously, and area from area. And after processing, when we have processed this, or we can say we run this block, then we find out the answers like this. Radius is equal to 12.5 that we have given. Radius here 12.5, then diameter is calculated, circumference and area. So this is the result for this block. So in this way we can create constants in our blocks, and then we can use that constants in our blocks. After that, we will go on the literals. So in literals, a literal is an explicit numeric character, string or a boolean value not represented by an identifier. For example, we can say true or any number 458, we can say. Then the null is basically a keyword we say it a literal. Not null can also be used here. True, false, both can be used here. Then any string in a single quotation marks, that can also be a literal. These are the type. True is basically related to the Boolean type literal, and 458, that is a numerical value, so number type. And null is also Boolean type, MMCS, that we have given in single quotation marks, so this is called string. So PL SQL literals are case sensitive. So if you are using it in uppercase, then same will be used throughout the blocks, and if you are assigning some value in the lowercase, then same will be used in the during the whole block. So in PL SQL, many types of literals can be supported. So there are basically five type of literals which PL SQL can support. First is numerical literals, which has numerical values. So 8765, that can be an example of the numerical literal. Character literals means the single character value in single quotation marks, that any character or any numerical value in a single quotation mark, that will also represent as a character. Then any special symbol in single quotation mark, that will also become a character value. So these are the examples of the character literals. Then string literals, they have more than one character in single quotation marks. So we can say hello students, that will become a string literal. Boolean literals means that can be true, false, null, not null, that also a Boolean literal. Then date and time are, if you are representing date, then it is also date and time literal. If you are representing date with time span, then that is also called date and time literals. You can use both, and you can use one also. So date and time, time only, date only. So these are the five types of literals which we can use in PL SQL. Here is an example how literals will work in your block or in your program. So we will again go on live script to show the use of literals. Here is the code. Declare, then messages, message varchar30. So we created a literal in form of a message. Previously we have also done this same program by printing hello message. So this is same as that. Then we created a literal using this, and then begin, we have just printed that literal in this, and after processing this and after running this program or block, we will get this result, because we just want to print the message and it will print here after processing of the literal. So to embed single quotes within a string literal, place two single quotation marks next to each other. So what we have to do, we have to start with a single quotation mark, then we have to write down the string value, and then we have to end with the single quotation marks. That is the form of a literal we can create or we can execute using SQL. So all this is related to the constants and literals. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you so much.